Who else but an avid, lifelong football fan would go through this much effort for the World Cup? Floridian Jolene Kane is a relatively new supporter and determined, it seems, to make up for lost time.
I just live for it now. This is a whole month of a lot of ups and sometimes some downs, but it's all good in between. Mm-hmm. And bring on World Cup. We're ready.
All right! Go England!
It's been 20 years since the US hosted the World Cup, but the sport still needs more people like Jolene and her husband John. Support is uneven at best, but the presence of superstars like David Beckham and his plans for US Major League Soccer have helped, as have changing demographics.
The biggest thing I'm looking forward to is all the colors, all the people representing their places they're from, and it's all for one unifying event, and that's really makes me happy.
I think it brings together everyone throughout the entire world. Everyone's kind of cheering for their country and kind of unites them. And everyone gets excited about it. It's not just one country.
Despite the obvious passion for the World Cup, football here still doesn't get the kind of audiences that, say, basketball and baseball does. It's certainly come a long way over the past few years, but most sporting pundits will tell you the beautiful game is nowhere near to challenging the sporting status quo.
All righty. Let's give it a go.
All right. Okay, coach.
Former player turned commentator Ray Hudson has been involved with football in the US for more than three decades. He's seen the sport mature, but says it may be years before football hits the big time.
It's something that isn't going to be done with one sweep of marketing or one World Cup, even in victory. I would suspect that wouldn't even shift the needle to being a soccer nation, a football nation.
Many here refer to football as the sleeping giant. It has grown in popularity among some, but remains on the fringes. But if Jolene Kane is any indication of what might happen, football could still have a chance in the US. Andy Gallagher, Al Jazeera, Miami, Florida.